In the year 2115, scientists identified a rogue class B star traveling towards us. Earth and the solar system would be destroyed. The Prolus ships were launched in 2149, three giant colony ships which carried thousands to a safe zone near Pluto. In 2151, the Earth was destroyed. With nowhere to go, our last resources were scrambled and five scout ships were sent to five distant worlds. These pioneers began our first interstellar journey, to boldly go where mankind may begin anew. Our last chance at survival is known as the Solus Project. Fifteen years later. Mission TSP-3 arrives at Gliese-6143-C. Alright, well, before we get to this, hey guys, welcome to After Work Gaming. Tonight we're going to check out the Solus Project. Now, I've had this game in my Steam library for a while, ever since it first hit Early Access back in the day, and I think I played maybe 10-15 minutes of it, and realized that I really wanted it to come out of Early Access before I got around to playing the story of it. And, you know, as things go, I just sort of lost track of it. And now, I'm back! And it's glorious. It's finished. It's, I think, optimized for graphics. And look, there's more stuff you can do. Before, you'd just be dumped on this planet and you're like, all right, go and explore. Right? If you guys have never heard of this game, it is a sci-fi exploration survival game where there are survival elements. You need to feed yourself and get water and sort of keep yourself warm and the rest of that stuff. But it's not this from what I remember, it's not an overwhelmingly crushing necessity in this game. It really is about exploring this alien planet, finding out what the heck happened. As you saw from the intro intro movie, something shoots off the planet and destroys the ship that we were on. And so now we need to go ahead and find out what the heck is going on and also contact, you know, our folks back in the solar system to tell them that something's going on. Okay? So that's what the game is. I will pick up with you guys in a second. I'm just going to set the parameters for the game, and I'll tell you what it is once I do it. So give me 1 second. Okay, and here we are. So what I did was I didn't take any bonuses. This is on normal with American, you know, measurements. So Fahrenheit, feet, miles, etc. I didn't take any bonuses because I don't want any of that stuff. I'm on normal because I'm not hardcore in this game, no way. And easy just seems unnecessary. And so let's go ahead and look around. Oh, there we go. World Independent Local Survival Overseer Node.
World Independent Local Survival Overseer Node active. Wilson interfacing with operator. Operator vital signs detected.
Error. Relay satellite is out of range. Great. Alright, speaking of contacting people, what do we have here? Aha, items have two states. Pick up an item or craft and combine an item. Okay, fine. But this is just a rock. Yeah, I could have told you that. Oh! A sharp rock. Okay, so we sharpen the rock down. Can we... Yeah, we can scroll through our inventory with the mouse wheel. What else do we have? Hold on. Okay, we have space for jump. We have shift to run, and it takes about a second to kick in. And then C is crouch, and it's a toggle crouch. Cool. Cargo net can be cut, requires a tool. Perfect. Alright. P, stats. B, sleep. O, objectives. Okay. Objective distance, world temperature, the health, body temperature, calories, water. Yeah, see, this is what I'm talking about, survival. You need sleep, you need water, you need to eat, you have to keep yourself at a certain temperature. This is just world circumstances, and your health, obviously. You can die in this game. Let's actually go see. P. Health limit, 600 of 1,000. Cool. Inventory limit, 12 of 16, 36. No bonuses. I think you can, like, upgrade your character, which is, you know, interesting. And objectives, there are no objectives. Okay. Come on. There we go. Yeah. Base bars to jump. Cool. Oh, because we can jump over this. Whoa. Stretch of Desolation 1. Ah, and Q toggles the whatever I have. Okay. What's this? A water bottle. Good. Take that. Food. Take that. And what's this? Survival Handbook page, 1 of 8. If you find yourself in a precarious situation, explore your surroundings and scavenge whatever useful items you can before conditions worsen. Ah, I see a breadcrumb trail. And I see another can. Well, it did say scavenge. Whoa. Okay. Food can. Closed. Craft. Sharp rock. Oh, can we open it? No, but we're not going to do that. We're going to pick it up. We're going to take the water bottle as well. What's this? A pipe. Cool. How do I open my inventory? I. No. Tab? Ooh. A pipe, two cans, two waters, a rock, and a sharp rock. Ah, 7 to 12. I can pick up 5 more items. I see. Ooh. Lata's Diary, 1126. I wonder what the public think of us. That we're a bunch of slacker scientists playing with fluids and zero-G and wasting time for 15 years? Maybe they think it's all a hoax? We watched the Q&A episode and everything felt so scripted and artificial. Ah. Okay. Sorry, guys. I'm like, losing my voice a little bit. Is there more in here? These, by the way, these rocks, these formations, are real. I forget. I will find out. I'll put it in the comments. I'm seeing more letters. What mineral does this? But, and I'll link to a photo of it on Earth. These things exist, and they're awesome. They're ridiculously awesome if you see them, even in photos. I've never seen them in person. But... Alright, let's see what we got. Lata's Diary, 1226. There's so many things that Prolis HQ, PBHQ, prohibit us from saying. Everyone we want to talk to has to sign an agreement not to tell anyone of what our discussions are about. Maybe Frederick Wright Frederick's right about them censoring us, but he loves his tinfoil hat. Okay. Lotta's Diary 13. Oh, of 26, I see. I saw Montserrat reading off a script Amon gave her. Apparently, the next episode will feature the pioneers from all the Solus ships. When Isabella and Hatim had their episodes, they weren't given any script. But Monty is a bit unpredictable. I see. Is it that the government doesn't have faith in what we do? This is pretty cool. And, huh? No. Okay, okay. This is a very cool... So when I played this game back in Early Access, I never got past this little area, and I've never really explored it as much as even now. I just kind of followed the breadcrumb trail over there. And that was it. Well, yeah, and I think that you get to a cave, and I stopped there. Because I'm like, I don't want to know what happens after this. I mean, you guys know, I like playing games. I like going in blind. I like not knowing anything about a game. At all, really. All right, the water bottle's messing me up. Okay, that's one of our ship's engines, apparently. From the look.
Please follow survival training.
Ooh. New forward vector.
It's all up in flames. I need to report back to Prolus Command somehow. Better have a look around and see if anyone or anything made it.
Ah, and a bunch of pipes. Okay, let's go back to the breadcrumb trail, right? Can we pick any of these flowers in the grand tradition of, you know, let's go punch trees or something? No? No. Where do we come? We come out here, right? We read this one, page one. Okay, let's read this. Page two, as soon as possible, secure a source of heat, fresh water, and food. All right, we got cans. Find a place to take shelter. How you deal with the first few hours is crucial for your survival. Alright, well, we have 4 cans of food, 2 bottles of water, which I'm assuming we could probably refill if we find a source. And, I mean, there you go, right? And a couple of rocks and a pipe. Fine. How much? We have 3 more items we can lift, or pick up. Okay. Survival Handbook 3. Stay dry, sleep well, and protect yourself during storms. Keeping well rested is vital to increasing your chances of survival. Rain or water can quickly lead to hypothermia during the night. Okay, where are we? 98.6, sure, why not? Calories, 2278, fine. Well, it's all going down, but it's not... It doesn't seem like it's going to pop an error or, you know, a warning for me anytime soon. Oh, I'm seeing cans, and where there are cans, maybe there's other stuff. At this point, I'm just looking for, like, paper. Let's take a can. If anything, we'll just drop it later on. Or maybe we can... If I remember correctly, we will find a cave. Maybe we can just stockpile some stuff. We can do like a Robinson Crusoe type of deal where we'll just like pick up everything on this beach. Okay, 4. Be careful not to get lost. Mark locations you have been to. Avoid getting trapped due to nightfall, rising tides, storms, losing your light source, and so on. That's a really cool cave. Really cool. Okay. H5. Once you have secured your environment, find a way to communicate with the outside world. Gather parts and build an impromptu transmitter. Never give up hope that you will be rescued, no matter how dire your situation. Yeah, that sounds like some platitude nonsense. Okay. What else we got? What else we got? So that's the cave, forward vector, right? That's pretty much where I stopped playing this game. In early access, and I... didn't get past the main menu when I was testing this for recording purposes. Wow. Whoa.
Dehydration imminent.
Oh, Jesus, fine. Whoa. Okay, maybe I won't run, but... Worship tabulate. Tabulate? One of one. 4x artifacts, 1x relic of day, 1x relic of night, 1x relic of athleticism. I don't have a map or anything, do I? No. Okay. What time is it? What temperature is it? It's 90 degrees outside. Holy moly, guys. What is this? A plant. It's edible. Yeah. What's it in the shade? It's 70 degrees in the shade. That's not great. Relic of night. Resistance to hypothermia plus 1%. Ooh. Nice! Okay, so I guess that's how we upgrade our skills and stuff. We locate things. We find things. Cool. Okay. Do we have a time? Is there an approximate time? No. I don't like the fact that... is the sun sinking? No, I don't know. But, hold on. We'll just take a quick jog over to this area, because I saw stuff, like, fall from the sky here, and I think it was these things. Maybe not. Okay, never mind. You guys saw it too, right? Like, things crash-landed here. Oh. Lotta's Diary, 15 of 26. I'm trying to keep my sanity by bouncing ideas with Frederic about the possibility of organic life forms on Gliese-6143-C. The rapid and extreme changes in the temperature should eliminate the possibility, and I'm curious to see how they manage to survive. Alright, we still got plenty of water in our system. Lotta's Diary, 16 of 26. Sophia hadn't been around much, so I visited her and got a nasty surprise. She looks and sounds awful. I think she's on the cusp of a breakdown. She said the things she thought would keep her strong were actually the things that broke her. Interesting. Oh, by the way, we have an empty bottle. So that's what we're holding in our hand. Backpack. Ooh. Nice. Yes, we upgraded our inventory. That's good. Which means we can take more of this stuff. Water and food. That's always good. And we can definitely craft. I'm assuming we can take the top off the can. Let's just see. You know, we read those. That's a pipe. We don't care about the pipe. We already have one. I'm sure we'll care about it in a second, but, you know. Lotta's Diary, 17 of 26. Frederic and I were going through some recent scans of the planet's surface. Advanced spectrographic analysis shows carbon compounds scattered on the surface. They line up almost perfectly with the areas I suspected plant life might be. Well, you were right. There is plenty of plant life. 15,000 calories. That's all right. Lotta's Diary, 18 of 26. I showed Corina our findings regarding the carbon compounds on Gliese. The image resolution of the orbiter is promising, but not good enough. We were counting the landers for the data. She said she would look into it further, though. That's something. Is something. Okay, and I'm sensing that the light is fading, so... Yes, let's take that. We can get water, and we can get food. Let's eat it. Nice! That's actually a really good thing to have. That's awesome. Like, really juicy, like, succulents or something that we're picking here. Is that a rock? That's a rock. No, nobody cares. No. That's another rock. Okay, note to self, there is another cave on this side, but it is dark and horrifying. Okay, we're not going to go in there yet. We will find, maybe we'll find like a flashlight or something and we'll come back and explore it. Yeah, give me the plant. That plant is money. Alright, we got one more, space for one more item. Okay. Alright, I'm hearing the telltale sound of... One relic of day. Is it telling me like what's in the area? Because we found a relic of night. I did not find a relic of day or any of that other stuff. Artifacts, I guess. Shh. Shh. Don't do the whole like howling winds thing yet, man. Unnecessary and not very cool. Let's take that water. What do we got here? 6 of 8. Craft the torch. A. Create a makeshift cutting tool using a rock. Sorry about that. Makeshift cutting tool using a rock. B. Cut off dry organic material. C. Wrap the material around some kind of handle. D. Apply oil to it if available. E. Light it on fire. Well, we got a sharp stone. I guess maybe we can use the pipe? Can we use the plant? No. Okay. What else we got? More pipe. Another can of food. Alright, let's at least go inside, yeah? Find a place to take shelter. Cool. What is this? Dry roots! Burnable. Can be cut. Requires a tool. Cut this. Perfect. Alright. But, we had a... for making a torch. And we do this. Nice. But of course now we need to burn it, and we have... Oh, I got a crazy idea, guys, but we'll do that in a second. I'm hearing water. Let's see if we can trickle... We can, like, collect water into this bottle. What's this? Water. Cool. Excellent. Drink from the fresh water fountain. Okay, we got water. Locate oil and apply it to the torch. Let me do the following. One. Two. Three. Why do I do that? Well, because I just want to store it here. Let's take this. And where are we? 17,000 calories, 97 degrees... 97... ounces of water in our system. That's fine. Woo! It's 40 degrees. That is rough. It was 90 in the sun. This is colder than it was in the shade. What's this? Oil. Endless torches. Holy moly. Nice. Locate oil and apply it to the torch. Perfect. Light the torch. Yeah, this is what I thought was going to have to happen. And I really am horrified that that's the answer. 80 degrees just here. 101 degrees just here. 114. Come on. Ah! Whoa. That was incredibly warm. New forward vector, explore. Act 1, The Awakening. Okay. What?
Solus 3, this is Prolus Command, calling from Deck 50 of Capital Ship Opez near Pluto. Checking in for a status update. We received a jumbled emergency reading from the satellite relay right before your designated landing time. Is everything okay? Your feed stopped a while ago. Solus 3, I don't want to panic you, but the other colony ships are getting antsy. If you succeed, we'll have a 15-year journey ahead. The team here are rooting for you. Prolus up.
Well, there we go. That's all we have time for in the connection. Damn it. Okay. Objectives, explore. Great. No active peak, survive 0 days. Prolus fleet time is... nighttime. Okay. I guess fleet time may be on local time for this planet or something. Because it is nighttime. Okay, let's... This is an endless torch now. Let's do this. Let's pick up what's left outside so I can bring it inside. Another tin can. Right. Can I gather mushrooms? No, I can't. No mushroom gathering for me. Okay. And let's drop this rock here. Thank you. 13 to 15. No, that's fine. We'll keep the pipe just in case we can make another tool with it. This is really good food because it gives us calories and water. This gives us just, I'm assuming, just food. Sharp rock, that's our multi-purpose tool. Water, okay, that's good. Okay, so this is dry roots. This is just regular water, right? Water, okay. That's cool. Oh, it is cold. It is very cold. 20 degrees. 23 degrees. 28 degrees. I see. It's just very cold in that cave. Okay. Okay, so here's what was gonna happen. We're gonna call it there for now. I feel like this was a nice little introduction. This is exactly where, not exactly where. I don't think I've ever re-established contact before. I think this cave is where I stopped playing in early access, and I am super intrigued by what's going on now. I didn't see the intro movie when I first played this game. You can only play as a guy when I first played, and we're playing as Olympia now. Yeah, I mean, I never managed to go past like that barricade to find that, you know, artifact of the night or whatever, relic of the night. So I'm curious. I am very curious about what this is all about. Wow, it is getting really cold. Holy moly, let's go back inside. Anything? A little bit? No? Okay, fine. Okay, so we'll keep it there. When we come back, we'll explore the cave around the back and then maybe walk down the beach and see what else we can find. Maybe update our collection of cans. And yeah, we'll take it from there. And obviously there's probably going to be more reading material, which is always welcome to me. If you guys enjoyed this, you know, like, comment, subscribe, tell a friend. Lets me know that I'm doing something right. Lets me know that you guys want to see more of this game. Speaking of, if you do want to see more, by all means, please leave me a comment. If you think I could do something differently, or if you have suggestions on how to play this game, or think I've overlooked something, or just don't want to see this game, you know, by all means, leave a comment. Everything's welcome, and in any case, I will see you all next time. Better,